الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم لك الحمد بديع السماوات والأرض ذا الجلال والإكرام رب الأرباب وإله كل مألوه وخالق كل مخلوق ووارث كل شيء ليس كمثله شيء وهو بكل شيء محيط. أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت الأحد المتوحد الفرد المتفرد، وأنت الله لا إله إلا أنت الكريم المتكرم العظيم. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أبي
طالب أمير المؤمنين.
اللهم صل على محمد
وعلى فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين.
اللهم صل على محمد
وعلى الحسن والحسين سيد الشباب أحلى الجنة.
اللهم صل على محمد
وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى محمد بن علي وعلى جعفر بن محمد وعلى موسى بن جعفر وعلى علي بن موسى وعلى محمد بن علي وعلى علي بن محمد وعلى حسن بن علي وعلى الخلف القائم المنتظر المهدي.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلي.
اللهم اجعل ظهورا انهم يرونه بعيدا ونراه قريبا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم افتح لي ابواب توبتك ورحمتك ورزقك الواسع اني اليك من الراغبين واتمم لي انعامك انك خير المنعمين. اللهم اجعل بقيه عمري في اداء فرض الجمعات والحج والعمره ابتغاء وجهك يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على محمد وعلى الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد.
اوصيكم بتقوى الله ونسم امركم. One of the resources which can make us muttaqi and help us to proceed on the way of taqwa, that is love of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Imam Radha alayhi as-salam, who is
our Allah. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
One day, Shah Abdul Azim, who was in Tehran, he asked our ninth Imam, Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Shah Abdul Azim asked, O Imam, I want to go for ziyarat, but right now I can do only one ziyarat. So what would you suggest to me, to go for Karbala, ziyarat of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, or I should go for ziyarat of Imam Raza alayhi salam in Mashhad? Imam Jawad alayhi salam replied, there are many people who are coming for ziyarat of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, so it is better to go ziyarat of Imam Raza alayhi salam. Even many Ismaili and Bohras, and many people who are not visiting 8th Imam, they are visiting Imam Hussain alayhi salam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
And another hadith which is given by our 7th Imam, Imam Musa Qasim.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
He said, anyone who will visit, because in the life of Imam Musa Qasim alayhi salam, Imam Raza alayhi salam was in Medina, he was alive. But Imam alayhi salam predicted and said, anyone who will visit the grave of my son Ali, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him with sawab of 70 hajj mabroor.
Subhanallah.
If you will go for hajj, there is no guarantee that hajj will be accepted. But anyone who will go for the ziyarat of Imam Raza alayhi salam, he will get reward of 70 hajj maqbool. Salman bin Humas, who was listening this, then he was amazed. He said, O Imam, is it true? By one ziyarat, I can get sawab of 70 hajj? Imam said, why are you getting amazed? Not only 70 hajj, but the zahir of Imam Raza alayhi salam can get sawab of 70,000 hajj mabroor.
Subhanallah.
And not only that, He will also do ziyarat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ashiq Khuda. And Imam alayhi salam furthermore he added, at the day of judgment, from Awwaleen there will be four messengers, and from Akhirin there will be four personality, altogether eight. From Awwaleen will be Nuh, Hazrat Ibrahim and Hazrat Musa and Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. From Akhirin, Hazrat Muhammad, Hazrat Ali, Imam Hassan.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
And all these eight personality, they will be at the highest place, and they will be next to throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ye aath hastiyan Allah ke arsh ke niche honge aur sabse buland maqam hoga inka. Imam alaihi salam farmate hain, Imam Musa Kazim alaihi salam, jo Imam Raza alaihi salam ke zawar, anyone who will visit Imam Raza alaihi salam, his status will be equal to status of these eight personalities, and they, he or she will stay.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali.
So there's a beautiful saying of our eighth Imam. He said, La yastakmilu abdun haqiqat al-iman hatta takuna fi khisal salatin. A person cannot attain the reality of iman, cannot attain the perfectness of iman until he has three virtues. And what are those? Tafaqqahu fi din. First thing, a believer must ponder, must think, must try to understand what is Islam. Most of us usually we are not reading, we are not trying to improve our knowledge. So as a believer, if we want to be Kamil Mu'min, we need to understand what is Islam, what is religion. First one is tafaqqu fi din, wa husnu taqdir fi al-ma'isha, and best of the planning for your business, for your job, for your life. That is, if you are good in a religion, it does not mean you should forget your life and your family. No, you should be same, at the same level. You should work for your iman, at the same time you have to work for your economy. وَصَبْرُ عَلَى الرَّضَايَا. And whenever any problem, any disease, anything is coming, for calamity is always the patient. So these three virtues, really, we should try to attain. Understanding of religion. Number two, developing our economy. Number three, whenever we are facing any problem, maybe physically, maybe spiritually, maybe anything, we should welcome that problem, and maybe that is our test for our iman. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Inna shani'aka huwal abtar.
Allahumma